There is no question that in the immediate aftermath of a concussion, many people experience profound cognitive difficulties, problems with memory, concentration, and even making everyday simple decisions. Where there's far less agreement is about what happens in the longer term. Are these problems persistent, and how long do they go on for? I work at Weston's Brain and Mind Institute, and in my lab, one of the things that we study are the long-term cognitive effects of concussion. A couple of years ago, we asked 20,000 people whether they had ever been concussed, and if so, how many concussions they had had during their lives. We were surprised that 3,750 people said that they had sustained at least one concussion. And in fact, the number of concussions ranged from 1 to 28. We then asked all of these volunteers to complete a series of online cognitive tests. These are tests that were developed in my lab at Weston, and we asked people to log into a website at cambridgebrainsciences.com and carry out tests of memory, concentration, problem solving, decision making, and much more. One of the most startling results was that those people who had been concussed reported having more difficulties concentrating and higher levels of anxiety and depression than those people who had not been concussed. As far as the cognitive data was concerned, there's both good and bad news. On the good side, in 11 of the 12 cognitive tests, there were no significant differences between the participants who had been concussed and the participants who had not been concussed. Now, why do I call this good news? Well, it means for many areas of cognition, and this includes memory and decision making, there appeared to be no long-term effects of concussion. Unfortunately, on one of the tests, on a test of inhibitory control, there was a profound deficit in those participants who had been concussed when compared to the non-concussed participants. And what's more, the number of concussions that they had predicted how poorly they performed on the task. Now, what is inhibitory control, and what does it mean when I tell you that these participants failed in a test of inhibition? Inhibitory control is a brain process that helps us to stop doing what might be our most immediate or impulsive response in any situation where generally we know that there is a better or a safer way to proceed. For example, accelerating towards an amber light in an effort to cross an intersection at the last minute when otherwise we should slow down and stop would be a good example of a failure of inhibitory control. Similarly, on the sports field or on the ice, a player with a problem of inhibitory control may be more likely to continue with a tackle long after they've heard the whistle to stop. Inhibitory control is really important in all sorts of everyday situations because a failure to inhibit can be dangerous and can lead to injury and even death. We then made a rather bold prediction. We reasoned that if concussion is associated with long-term deficits of inhibitory control in the general population, then it might be a particular problem for sports people who engage in activities that involve repetitive impacts to the head. We recruited a group of 74 varsity football players. Now, these football players all played on a university team, and between them, on average, they had 7.5 years of competitive sport under their belts. Of course, we wanted to compare them to another athletic group, but a group that didn't typically involve themselves in activities that involved blows to the head, so we chose a matched group of varsity rowers. Amazingly, we saw exactly the same pattern of results in the varsity footballers that we'd seen in the general population of concussed participants. That is to say, they were unimpaired on 11 of the 12 tests, but on the one test of inhibitory control, they had a really profound deficit. Now, just to give you some perspective into what this deficit was like, the test only lasts 90 seconds. Yet, on average, the footballers were making an error of inhibitory control once every 8 seconds. Every year, there are millions of traumatic brain injuries around the world, and the overwhelming majority of those are diagnosed as concussion. What our studies have shown is that far from being a short-term problem, cognitive deficits, or specifically an impairment of inhibitory control, is a long-term consequence of concussion, both in varsity footballers and in the general population. Thank you.